Hi folks, I'm Stephen from the Gold Coast Art School and I've just been painting. No, I haven't. I didn't paint that. What we're going to talk about today is care of brushes. It's important to keep your brushes clean. I see what happens with a lot of students and they haven't got time, they're rushing off to lunch or whatever and they don't wash their brushes and they bring them back next week and they're like that. First of all, dry clean them. So really give it a thorough clean. Get as much out as you can. Use a tissue if you like, that works fine. At the art school we use this because lots of students, so we go through truckloads of this stuff, mineral turpentine. I caught one student using that and freaked out. Really, seriously, you don't use gum turpentine to clean your brushes with, not unless you're the sort of person that likes bathing in ass's milk. This is for painting. That's for cleaning brushes. Drying, that's about okay. Can you see that? Now, first of all, dip it in the holy waters of the Ganges, mineral turpentine. Get as much out as you can, really work it in there. What can happen with an older brush too is it starts to ride up into the ferrule. This metal bit's called the ferrule. What happens is paint finds its way up in there. Really is important to get that clean, because if you were going to use blue one day and then the next day you're doing a beautiful pale pink portrait, what happens is that the oil paint has got gum turpentine in it, it's got thinners in it, it'll ease its way up and then pull the paint, which hasn't quite dried yet, out of the ferrule into your brush, and lo and behold, your Gainsborough has this really ugly blue streak across it, which you probably didn't want. That's how much we got out the first time. So give it another blast and really jump it up and down, push it through. And now see how that terps is starting to look pretty well clean. You don't chuck that terps out, you can recycle that for the next day. Now, it is possible, if you're going to be painting on a regular basis, that might be sufficient for one day. But if you're a hobby painter that only goes near your brushes once a week, you really need to take better care of them. Now, what we do at the school, look at that beautiful artifact here. Ancient piece of soap. Not really, that's probably bought a couple of weeks ago. What we do is wet the brushes and work it in there. It helps pull the paint out and then rinse it and then it's fine. Once we've washed it clean, we use this stuff, petroleum jelly. And then what we do is with a bit of the petroleum jelly, we shape the brush. Why do we do that? Is because sometimes when they dry out, they open up. Why? Because there's possibly still some paint hiding down there and has the effect of pushing the brush open. Here's a classic example. This is a beautiful liner brush. These aren't cheap and they're designed for holding lots of paint but giving you a beautiful line. I'm going to do a chat about all the different brushes and what you can do with them later. But once you thumb and forefinger and you put it away like that, now that's holding its shape. Now, what do we do with things like this one? This one and this one are both hog's bristle brushes. Compared to these, this is what we call a Tacklon. It's a synthetic brush. When you're washing them out with soapy water, you don't want to go too hot. Keep it tepid. Hog's bristles are, they can take a little bit more heat, so you can be a bit more brutal with them. There's lots of products on the market. We just use normal soap, it's fine. But there are some super products out there. They're industrial strength cleaners. This one's called Incredible Brush Cleaner. It's by an Aussie mob. And what you do, it's very, very concentrated. I reckon all it is just industrial strength Sard soap. So if you've got any Sard soap, there's a free plug. Guess what, it won't come out. Can we cut?
Yes.
We've been on holidays, thank you, Mr. Virus. And so this is dried up in the meantime. Now, you don't need much of this stuff. It's very concentrated. And what you do, just gently push that in and keep pushing at it. They claim a brush can be 2 years old, had dried paint in it for 2 years old, and it was still clean. If you were using just normal soap, you'd have to repeat it about 20 or 30 times. I'm just going to leave that like that Then add a little bit of, this has not got hot water in it, it's got a little bit of warm water in it. All you do is just pour that in up to the ferrule, just cover it like that and leave it overnight to soak a little bit and give it a bit of a tease and push it up in there some more, and we'll come back and have a look at that later. Good morning, good morning. Here we are again. Different lighting, different shirt. Look at that. See how much garbage? I have given that a bit of a stir already to see if it was all right, but look how much paint's come out of that. So what we're going to do now is just take them out, wipe that off, give it a slosh. This is just clean water. With all processes like this, if it's not really clean enough, then you just repeat it. But this overnight soaking, remember the one I showed you yesterday that was like a rock hard stick? Silky smooth. I think I wash my own hair in this. That's not a very expensive brush, but it's worth keeping, it's worth looking after. If you look after your brushes, they will last a lifetime. I've been professionally painting for many, many years now. I've got brushes I've had for 30 years. They're worn down, but they still work and they still do something. What we do now, see that's still pulling stuff out. Look at that, it's changing color as we go. So it's just, that's just, this stuff here is just drawn, it's melted the paint, it's sucked it out of the ferrule, it's regained its sensitivity. When you store them, just thumb and forefinger, a little bit of petroleum jelly there. Petroleum jelly is compatible with your oil paint, so it doesn't matter so much. If you were doing acrylic brushes, then probably it would be best to rinse these out, wash these out again before you start working with acrylics. But the idea is just see how that's shaping up nicely. It's an old brush, it's worn out in the middle, and it's never gonna be a perfect brush. But at least it doesn't have that dunny brush look about it now. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Do you want to tell people to subscribe and...
No, I don't know how to do that. You'll have to do all that.
Thank you for watching, everybody. I hope that you enjoyed. And if you would like to, please subscribe. Please give it a like. And you can even tell us what you would like to learn next.
Yes.
Yay. Thank you so much, everybody.
Bye.